In 1984, the Guinness Book of World Records acknowledged that the greatest living explorer was Sir Ranulph Fiennes. He's not sat on his laurels since then. This man is a legend. He climbed Mount Everest. Not that unusual, you might say, but he was 65 at the time. He was in the British Army, or the Army as we call it. For a time he was also in the SAS, but they threw him out after he borrowed some explosives for a mission of his own devising. Look it up, it is a most interesting story. Fiennes is best known as a polar explorer. If anybody knows what the shape of the world is, it is Sir Ranulph Fiennes, because he has crossed it at the surface, using the most insane route imaginable. Between 1979 and 1982, he travelled around the Earth, pole to pole, using surface transport all the way. A barking mad escapade that nobody has ever attempted before or since. But he did it, including making the Northwest Passage in an open whaler. In 1993, he beat that. He circumnavigated the entire flat planet on its rim. He walked around the world at its widest point, on foot, unaided, but for his one companion, who walked along with him, and they did it in only 93 days. Of course, this is preposterous. It is not possible to do that. But for a flat Earth model, he must have done that. What he actually did was cross the continent of Antarctica from coast to coast via the South Pole, of course. Walking to the South Pole is quite a sane thing for Ranulph Fiennes. That was a bit tame for the chap, so he tried to walk to both the North and South Pole, on separate occasions, entirely on his own, but he failed on both attempts. He understands the nature of challenge, and he knows how to survive. His Everest climb was on the third attempt. When he suffered severe frostbite in his fingers, and he was told he needed them amputated, he went along with this, to a point. Then the pain got too much, and he went out to his shed and chopped the ends of his fingers off with a fret saw. There's a phrase that is beloved of many obituary writers. He didn't suffer fools gladly. I suspect that when the time comes, this will be said of Ran Fiennes. I have no intention of debating the preposterous notion of a flat earth with anybody. I have wasted far too much time on that absurd idea already. I know the shape of the earth because it has been a reality for me for many years. I have been frustrated and challenged by the shape of the earth many times. Take my word for it or don't. Either way, I am not going to explain it to you. This flat Earth nonsense is a snare which seems to be designed specifically to divert attention away from matters that are actually important. So I'm going to bury it all now. Here is your challenge. I want anybody who believes in a flat Earth to meet Sir Ranulph Fiennes face to face, toe to toe, and tell him that he did not cross Antarctica and that he is a liar. I'll hold your coat.